Hello and welcome to my channel and inside my garage. Today I'm gonna be replacing the HEPA filter in my Model S. This instructions that I'm gonna show you can apply to any Model S or X for that matter from 2016 all the way up until now, so late 2020. It's all the same. Even if you don't have a Biodefense mode when you purchase your car and Tesla charges $500 for it, this will be very useful for you because you actually can have absolute exact same benefits without paying $500. So I'm gonna be using aftermarket part. This is a huge, ginormous filter. It's actually better than Tesla standard filter. I can just promise you that. And guess what? It costs $50 because you're paying only for a filter. When you'd go through Tesla and paying them $500, they're replacing the whole assembly. It's like a plastic piece where the actual filter glued onto. You don't have to do that. Very wasteful, very expensive. You have to drop off your car. Well, unless mobile service do that, but then again, it's gonna cost you $500. You can do it yourself and you can install a better filter. And nowadays in 2020, the craziest year ever, you know, I have at least seen, this is a very valuable thing to have, is a good filtration in your car, good and healthy air. And I'm gonna walk you through step by step on how to do it and how to change your filter on your car. Let's go, let's get it done. All right, the very step that needs to be done is to remove all these plastic parts. Just gently with your fingers. You don't even really need any tools. Just lift them up carefully. There is no rush. They all being held just by clips. So there is no screws or anything like this. And just like that, it is gone. And you can set it aside. We're not gonna need it. So the next part is we need to remove this little holder on top, which is being held by three little screws right here. One, two, three. They all need to be removed just by simply lifting them up in the middle. Let me get a proper tool for that first. All right, with something like this, we can pop these little tabs. Nice and easy, they're plastic. Of course, it's Tesla, so you don't want to break them. There you go. And also you don't want to lose them, so just place them, I don't know, inside the frunk. They're not gonna run away anywhere from there. There's a second, and there is the last one, the third. There you go, nice and easy. All right, they're all the same size. However, I actually don't want to focus. Here we go. They're all the same size. However, I actually seen the videos when one of them is slightly longer, one of them is slightly shorter. Don't worry about it. That's just Tesla being Tesla. I can assure you, they're all the same and they're gonna work just fine. Even if one of them is longer, don't worry about it, like, oh my gosh, where does it go, in the middle or in the left? It's the same, it doesn't matter. Just trust me on this one. So now there's two tubes on the side, one from this side and one from a very opposite side. There's two actual tubes connected to this plastic piece. Just to remove the condensate, I think. So there's one, there you go. See this little guy? Okay, don't worry about it, it's not gonna go anywhere. So you have to pull out the second tube, nice and gentle. We can just go ahead and remove the liner. Okay, we can remove the liner. Don't worry, it's easy to reassemble. Again, we can put it inside, it's not a big deal. This will give you a little bit more space to work with. So there's two tabs on the end of this piece, one on the left, one on the right. And you kind of have to use your fingers a little bit under this plastic piece in order to let it loose. Here we go. Even my weak fingers were able to do that. There you go. And now you can see it's absolutely loose. This stuff is also gone. I will put it aside as well. Next step is to remove this plastic piece, which is, yes, you guessed it, it's Tesla. It's just laying around there. There's not even a clip. So just put it up and squeeze it out just like this. You can see no clips, no nothing. Don't worry, it's not just your Model S or X weird like this. It's just, it is what it is. Put it aside. We're not gonna need it for now. Also important note, when you're putting it back, I'm not sure the last person who was reassembling, probably me, so blaming myself, but this little sticker has to always stick out right about here so that first responders, just in case, they know where to cut this little nice cable, which is very important in case something actually happens. So now we can remove the liner, and don't just pull it out. There is one button right over here. To release, just disconnect that, and there's one light. My light is replaced with Abstract Ocean. It's a very nice light. All right, we're gonna remove that. Here we go. Just put it in the front, it's okay. So now we can remove the entire liner. Push those cables inside so they're not on your way. There you go. And just like that, the liner is off. Now we have inside of a actual frunk. Look at how nicely this seal that I have a sand inside. Very nice. So the frunk is being held, I believe, only by two screws, if I'm not wrong. Just this guy and that guy. Bunch of other screws that you see here is actually holding exactly the part that we need, the filter, the whole filter assembly. This guy, this is intake. So when you order this replacement of your filter for through Tesla, they threw out the entire plastic piece and the filter and everything in it. So very wasteful. Maybe that's why it's very expensive, but I'm not willing to find out why. I'm just gonna do it myself and forget about it. The tool you need is the 10 millimeter one. Just like that, 10 millimeter, all right? That's basically the only tool you need for this installation as of right now. So, all right, let's unscrew this. All right, that's the second screw. Put it right there. So now, before we move any further, we need to remove the sides. This side and that side. I believe we're gonna also need to remove the front, but let's just give it a second. So we need to remove this and this. Now you can, again, it's held on by a little plastic clips all around, so just use your fingers, prop it gently, little by little, and it's off, just like that. Same goes with the other side. Just like that, we're not gonna need it. Yes, we're gonna need to remove this part as well, so the same thing. Little clips, and I believe in the middle, there is going to be a little bit harsher metal clip, which is some people accidentally break. Right about this one. So it's right in the middle, so be gentle with this, don't break it. And the other ones is just a plastic clips. So like this guy, right here, so nothing too overcomplicated, so it's not a bad deal. There's another clip right here, two clips. Just using the same tool as I used before. Pop one clip right here, nice and easy. There you go. So the whole thing moves just like that. All right, here we go. Just like this, you see, so only two screws for the whole frunk. Oh, I forgot to move the cables, that's what was holding on. And of course, me being me, I mess up the audio from now on, I would have to do a voiceover. After deattaching the actual filter from a frunk, this is what you have, a ginormous plastic box with a filter inside. All you would have to do is remove the actual filter from inside. Don't worry about the soft part that I'm showing right now. This is just from dampening, from sounds and all that stuff. Don't worry about it, we don't have to remove it. So you can use your hand, screwdriver, knife, anything you'd like. Don't worry, you're not gonna damage anything. Just be careful with your fingers and deattach the old filter from the plastic assembly. Use any force necessary. Don't worry, there is no fragile parts. When you remove that part, you're gonna have a clean plastic piece assembly, which exactly all the parts, non-biodefense cars already have. So basically you guys already one step ahead of the game. You don't have to do a cleanup of a glue. Make sure you actually use the proper glue when you assemble yours. Don't just put it inside, put your filter inside without nothing. Use some silicone or some, you know, non-toxic glue that all the way around seemingly. Make sure don't leave any cracks there. Very important part, airflow. Make sure the airflow goes from the trunk towards the cabin. That's the right way to do it, and this is a very important part. Otherwise you're gonna, you know, lose a lot of efficiency and quality in your air filtration. So that's the way to do it. This filter fits absolutely perfectly. It's identical to the size to original Tesla, so don't worry about that. And as long as you put it back inside the way it should be, all you have to do is follow all the steps we took exactly backwards, and you're all set. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope this really helped you. And I see you soon. Thank you. Bye-bye.